1665. April 3rd. Up and to the Duke of Albemarle and Whitehall, where much business. Thence home and to dinner, and then with Creed, my wife, and Mercer to a play at the Duke's of my Lord Orre's, called Mustapha. All the pleasure of the play was the King and my Lady Castlemaine were there, and pretty witty Nell at the King's house, and the younger Marshal sat next us, which pleased me mightily. 30th, Lord's Day. The fleet, with about 106 ships upon the coast of Holland, in sight of the Dutch, within the Texel. Great fears of the sickness here in the city, it being said that 2 or 3 houses are already shut up. God preserve us all. June 7th. This day, much against my will, I did in Drury Lane see 2 or 3 houses marked with a red cross upon the doors, and Lord have mercy upon us writ there, which was a sad sight to me, being the first of the kind that, to my remembrance, I ever saw. It put me into an ill conception of myself and my smell, so that I was forced to buy some rolled tobacco to smell to and chaw, which took away the apprehension. 15th. The town grows very sickly, and people to be afeard of it. They're dying this last week of the plague 112, from 43 the week before. Whereof but one in Fanchurch Street, and one in Broad Street, by the Treasurer's office. 30th. Thus this book of 2 years ends. Myself and family in good health, consisting of myself and wife, Mercer, her woman, Mary, Alice, and Susan, our maids, and Tom, my boy, in a sickly time of the plague growing on. Having upon my hands the troublesome care of the Treasury of Tangier, with great sums drawn upon me, and nothing to pay them with. Also, the business of the office great. Consideration of removing my wife to Woolwich, she lately busy in learning to paint, with great pleasure and success. All other things well, especially a new interest I am making by a match in hand between the eldest son of Sir G. Carteret and my Lady Jemima Montague. July 1st. To Westminster, where I hear the sickness increases greatly. Sad at the news that 7 or 8 houses in Basinghall Street are shut up of the plague. July 5th. Up and advised about sending of my wife's bedding and things to Woolwich, in order to her removal thither. In the afternoon, I abroad to St. James's, and there with Mr. Coventry a good while. From thence, we walked round to Whitehall, the park being quite locked up. To Sir G. Carteret, and mightily glad he is to see me, and begun to talk of our great business of the match, how matters are quite concluded with all possible content between my lord and him, and signed and sealed, so that my Lady Sandwich is to come thither tomorrow or next day, and the young lady is sent for, and all likely to be ended between them in a very little while, with mighty joy on both sides, and the King, Duke, and Lord Chancellor, and all mightily pleased. By water to Woolwich, where I found my wife come, and her 2 maids, and very prettily accommodated they will be, and I left them, going to supper, grieved in my heart to part with my wife. Late home, and to bed, very lonely. 13th. By water at night, late to Sir G. Carteret's, but there being no oars to carry me, I was fain to call a sculler that had a gentleman already in it, and he proved a man of love to music, and he and I sung together the way down with great pleasure, and an incident extraordinary to be met with. Thence, after long discourse, I and my wife, who by agreement met here, took leave, and I saw my wife a little way down, it troubling me that this absence makes us a little strange instead of more fond, and so parted, and I home to some letters, and then home to bed. Above 700 died of the plague this week. 21st. So home, and late at my chamber, setting some papers in order. The plague growing very raging, and my apprehensions of it great. So very late to bed. 26th. Up, and after doing a little business, down to Deptford, with Sir W. Batten, and there lift him, And I to Greenwich, to the park, where I hear the King and Duke are come by water this morn from Hampton Court. They asked me several questions. The King mightily pleased with his new buildings there. Down to Woolwich, and there I just saw and kissed my wife, and saw some of her painting, which is very curious, and away again to the King, and back again with him in the barge, hearing him and the Duke talk, and seeing and observing their manner of discourse. And God forgive me, though I admire them with all the duty possible, yet the more a man considers and observes them, the less he finds of difference between them and other men, though, blessed be God, they are both princes of great nobleness and spirits. Duke of Monmouth is the most skittish, leaping gallant that ever I saw, always in action, vaulting or leaping or clambering. The sickness is got into our parish this week, and is got, indeed, everywhere, so that I begin to think of setting things in order, which I pray God enable me to put both as to soul and body. 27th, to Hampton Court, and dispatched all my business, and so stayed and saw the King and Queen set out towards Salisbury, and after them the Duke and Duchess, whose hands I did kiss. And it was the first time I did ever, or did see anybody else, kiss her hand. It was a most fine, white, and fat hand. It was pretty to see the young, pretty ladies dressed like men in velvet coats, caps, with ribbons, and with laced bands, just like men. Only the Duchess herself, it did not become. August 31st. Up. And, after putting several things in order, to my removal to Woolwich. The plague having a great increase this week, beyond all expectation of almost 2,000, making the general bill 7,000, odd 100, and the plague above 6,000. Thus this month ends with great sadness upon the public, through the greatness of the plague everywhere through the kingdom almost. Every day sadder and sadder news of its increase. In the city died this week 7,496, and of them 6,102 of the plague. But it is feared that the true number of the dead this week is near 10,000, partly from the poor that cannot be taken notice of through the greatness of the number, and partly from the Quakers and others that will not have any bell ring for them. Our fleet gone out to find the Dutch, we having about 100 sail in our fleet, and in them the sovereign one, so that it is a better fleet than the former with the Duke was. September 20th. Up, and after being trimmed, the first time I have been touched by a barber these 12 months, I think, and more, went to Sir J. Minns, and thence to the Duke of Albemarle. But Lord, what a sad time it is to see no boats upon the river, and grass grows all up and down Whitehall Court, and nobody but poor wretches in the streets. And which is worst of all, the Duke showed us the number of the plague this week, brought in the last night from the Lord Mayor, that it is increased about 600 more than the last, which is quite contrary to all our hopes and expectations from the coldness of the late season. November 15th. The plague, blessed be God, is decreased 400, making the whole this week but 1,300 and odd, for which the Lord be praised. December 31st, Lord's Day. All the morning in my chamber, writing fair the state of my Tangier accounts, and so dined at home. In the afternoon to the Duke of Albemarle, and thence back again by water, and so to my chamber to finish the entry of my accounts, and to think of the business I am next to do. And upon this late, and with my head full of this business, to bed. Thus ends this year, to my great joy, in this manner. I have raised my estate from £1,300 in this year to £4,400. But many of such as I know very well, dead. Yet to our great joy the town fills apace and shops begin to open again. Pray God, continue the plague's decrease, for that keeps the court away from the place of business, and so all goes to rack as to public matters, they at this distance not thinking of it.